Hello and welcome our blood viewers to RTD's News English Edition. As usual, we bring to you the major and top highlights of tonight. Let's follow. دخل in towards sustainable waste management. And on the international scene in Middle East, OIC condemns any assassination. Those were the major and top highlights. Welcome back to our newsroom, our blood viewers. The President of the Republic, His Excellency Mr. Ismail Omar Guelleh, sent a congratulatory message to the President of the Ivory Coast, Mr. Alassane Ouattara, on the occasion of his country's National Day. In his message, the President of the Republic, on behalf of the Djiboutian people, the government, and himself personally, expressed his warmest and heartfelt congratulations to his counterpart from Ivory Coast. He wished him good health and happiness and wished the people continued progress and prosperity. At the end of his message, the President of the Republic renewed his best wishes to the government and the people of Ivory Coast on this happy occasion. The city of Alisebe is preparing to celebrate International Youth Day, organized by the Ministry of Youth and Culture, with a series of events and activities bringing together youth from the capital and other regions. This gathering represents a significant moment for the region, highlighting the commitment of youth to sustainable development. Under the theme From Clicks to Progress, youth's digital journeys for sustainable development, workshops, conferences, various cultural activities and fields visits will be organized to encourage active participation and exchange among the youth. The events will include discussions on the diverse challenges faced by young people, local artistic performances, and networking opportunities. Local authorities expressed their happiness with this event, emphasizing its importance in strengthening social cohesion and encouraging youth engagement in community affairs. Visitors and residents in the area can expect a dynamic and enriching day characterized by strong participation from local and regional youth. The event aims to create a space where young people can express their ideas, share their experiences, and collaborate for a better future.
دد حريره ديغان لبدون لنا دلحيسا يو تقندوقه على السبيح مولو قدي معلن تجيو خيرك دين دلق ما شوبي دد حريره ديغان لبدون لنا دلحيسا يو تقندوقه على السبيح
Leading a high-level delegation, the Chief of Staff of the Djiboutian Armed Forces, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, visited the capital of the Alisebeh region. This visit is part of the Youth Brigade in Alisebeh event organized by the Ministry of Culture and Youth in the Republic of Djibouti. Upon his arrival at the Armed Forces Barracks in Alisebeh, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim was welcomed by the commander of the Armed Forces Battalion in Alisebeh, along with regional authorities and officials from the security forces and national gendarmerie stationed in the region. The purpose of the Chief of Staff's visit to the Alisebeh Armed Forces Barracks was to closely inspect the preparations underway to welcome the youth participating in the major event. On this occasion, the Alisebeh Joint Battalion Barracks were selected to accommodate more than 600 young people from all over the country. This large gathering will begin on the afternoon of Thursday, August 8th, which is today, and continue until the following Monday. General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim and his accompanying delegation inspected the accommodation camps for the participants. This field visit by the military delegation allowed them to ensure that everything is ready to welcome the youth under the best possible conditions. The Youth Brigade initiative is a significant moment for Djiboutian youth, serving as a unique gathering to promote national unity, personal development, and a sense of citizenship among Djiboutian youth. These young people will participate in a series of enriching activities ranging from educational workshops to cultural competitions.
Askariyo, askariyo,
The National Association of Local Authorities today organized the first monitoring and evolution mission for the waste management project in the Mulud district of the Dekhr region. This event was attended by the President of the Regional Council of Dekhr, Mr. Mahd Hussein, along with the main partners in this ambitious project and other invited guests. This project, implemented by the National Association of Local Authorities in Djibouti and funded by the International Association of Francophone Mayors, demonstrates the National Association of Francophone Mayors' commitment to working closely with community organizations involved in civil law for regional development, particularly in regional development and waste management in the Dekhr region. The primary goal of the mission was to assess the progress made so far and identify the challenges encountered. This initiative aims to improve the living environment in Mulud residents by establishing effective household waste management, thus contributing to a cleaner and healthier environment. Discussions also focus on raising public awareness on the harmful effects of the household waste. The National Association of Local Authorities, in collaboration with the International Association of Francophone Mayors, will continue to work closely with local authorities, civil society organizations, and communities to ensure the success of this initiative. After the technical meeting on monitoring the waste management project in Mulud by the Adar Association, Mr. Mahd Hussein, President of the Regional Council of Dekhr, went to Mulud with the regional directors of the technical team of the National Association of Local Authorities. The purpose of this visit was to assist the progress of work in establishing the landfill. The President of the Regional Council took this opportunity to discuss with local residents the issues and benefits of the waste management project. The local residents expressed their happiness with the launch of this important project, and Mr. Mahd Hussein, President of the Dekhr Regional Council, expressed his satisfaction with the good progress of the work in his collaboration with the Adar Association. The President of the Adar Association thanked the local authorities in Dekhr for their trust and technical support. Under the sponsorship of the State Secretary in Charge of Sports, the For the Future Association in Sagalu concluded its summer football tournament, an event the town organizes annually during the summer season. The closing ceremony of this tournament, which was met with great enthusiasm by the local population, was attended by regional authorities, representatives of the State Secretary for Sports, as well as local elders and people. The regional authorities praised the performance of the two teams that excelled in the summer championship, expressing their gratitude to the local authorities in the area for their efforts to ensure the success of the tournament. They noted that this sports event would contribute to enhancing and developing national sports and discovering new football talents. At the conclusion ceremony, the two teams that played in the final match and several other teams that ranked high in the tournament were honored. Shifting gears towards the international scene now, the Organization of Islamic Cooperation on Wednesday held Israel fully responsible for the assassination of Hamas political bureau chief Ismail Haniyeh last week in Tehran, warning that this heinous attack undermines security and stability in the region. The general director of the World Health Organization announced on Wednesday that he would convene a meeting with experts to determine whether the increasing spread of monkeypox in Africa warrants declaring a global emergency. WHO General Director Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus said at a press conference in Geneva that given the increasing spread of monkeypox cases outside the Congo, he decided to seek the advice of WHO's independent experts as soon as possible. Well, by this, our blood viewers, we finally conclude this edition. Thank you for being with us, and make sure to tune in later for more. Have a wonderful evening. Take care.